As part of my training as a pediatric upper extremity specialist, I do a lot of brachial plexus work. I'm the director of our brachial plexus clinic here for the University of Maryland Medical System. And at points that, at times that involves doing major operations on little babies, so anywhere from 3 to 6 months of age, doing a full dissection here in the neck area and finding the brachial plexus nerves that were damaged, usually during the birthing process. And at that point in time, we have to separate the nerves which are near and close to vital structures. We have to make sure that we don't damage those and then cut out the bad part of the nerve and basically stitch it back together to create good nerve to regain function in the child's arm. The outcomes are usually excellent. 80 to 90% of the time, the child regains function, whereas before the operation, they couldn't bend their elbow. And after the operation, as I say, 80 to 90% of the time, they're able to bend their elbow and get their hand to their mouth to help with feeding, hygiene care for their face, doing their hair, things like that. So there are children that are born missing fingers or extra fingers. For example, a child born without a thumb, we can actually take the index finger and make that into a thumb. That's called a pollicization procedure. And we can actually give the child the ability to pinch and grasp, which is what makes us as humans special compared to other species. So extrajudicial polydactyly is one of the most common congenital anomalies that we see. Most commonly we see it in African-American children on the pinky side where they have extra pinkies. And you can actually see it in both hands and even both feet. That is hereditary and is passed on from generation to generation. And it's a fairly simple and easy operation to get rid of that extra digit if the family so chooses. Additionally, in Caucasian families, we tend to see extra thumbs, in which case we do operations to get rid of an extra thumb. Usually the whole thumb is not duplicated, but a portion of the thumb is duplicated. And that involves a little bit of trickier operation to combine the two thumbs and make a good thumb out of it. And I think just taking the time and making the environment fairly low key will help the children and the parents have a more favorable experience with the physician, which that's the environment I try and promote in the office. As you can see, I don't even wear a jacket, tie, or a white coat. I think that just enhances the difficulty in dealing with the children. I try and keep the atmosphere upbeat, positive, and try and make it as enjoyable as possible, despite the fact that they are in a doctor's office.